The main object of my visit is to attend the dedication of the memorial to George Catlett Marshall in the city of Frankfort day after tomorrow. While here in Bonn, I hope to pay my respects to Chancellor Earhart and Foreign Minister Schroeder. I welcome this opportunity to repeat to the Chancellor in person my country's message of warm good wishes on his assumption of his new post. I hope also to see Dr. Adenauer, who has so recently laid down the burdens of office he carried so long and with such great distinction to himself and to his nation and to the free world. And as you may be aware, the chiefs of United States missions in Europe currently meeting here in Bonn, and I will participate in their discussions. I come to Germany, as always, with the feelings of respect and friendship which have characterized our relationships for many years. It's very good to be here again.
Mr. Secretary? Does the success of Operation Big Lift mean we are going to withdraw troops from Germany?
The success of Operation Big Lift means that today we have more power in Germany than Germany has ever had here in Germany in its history. Let's really go to the latter for Sunday. Right?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Here I would register two warnings. First, the Soviet Union has not abandoned its goal of world domination or its determination to push toward that goal by every means safe for them. And secondly, the limited agreements we recently have reached with the Soviet Union do not yet constitute a détente. I hope that the alliance as a whole can meet its goals. In a genuine partnership, burdens must be equitably borne, and all countries must contribute their fair share to the total strength of the alliance. And we earnestly hope that it will do so. Since you are the Federal Republic and we are the United States are carrying the heaviest burden of NATO forces, let me speak to you very frankly. You and we are working in the closest partnership in NATO. We consult each other intimately. When we say that your defense is our defense, we mean it. And we have proved it in the past, and we will continue to demonstrate it in the future. Does the airlift of an armored division mean the withdrawal of American troops from Germany? The answer is no. The opposite is the case. Because of this airlift, we have at the moment a 7th division temporarily in Europe. And as you know, equipment is in position for still another division. Thus, the airlift capability developed by the United States at such great expense provides a major source of added strength to the alliance.